Good afternoon. Today I will tell you how to check your hard drive using the Victoria program. Why is it necessary? Sometimes the computer simply does not start the operating system. In this case, you also need to check the hard drive for damage. It may also be that the computer has simply become slow. This is also one of the symptoms of hard drive problems. You need to check it. This means that first of all we need to connect the hard drive to the computer, that is, we will not be able to check on a non-working computer, respectively. Or is there another option to make a bootable USB flash drive, place the Victoria program there and boot the computer already bootable flash drives and then check we will connect using a SATA to USB adapter and... In principle, there are a great many of these adapters, so I opened a page on AliExpress. There are different plans. Really different.
Usually now.
3.5 inches are extremely rare. Hard drives are usually all 2.5 inches SATA connectors on laptops. I come across other ports extremely rarely, specifically I use this adapter. It can be used either to connect just an external hard drive or to check it. This is how it looks like here we connect the hard drive. Here USB port, by the way, USB here 3.0, here it is shown in principle in the pictures how this is done, what drives it supports, and written up to a maximum of 4 terabytes, an additional power supply can also be connected. Here the connection is also shown simply how you can connect it as an external drive, but now we will use it to check the hard drive for errors, so we will check it. I will repeat the Victoria program. This is the website of the official program for professional data recovery. It means it is positioned Victoria is the best free program for diagnosing, research, testing and minor repairs. I should note that the program has recently, in 2019, the author resumed work on it and it changed quite often, that is, new versions were released. We can see the current, most recent one to date, is version 1523 dated December 31, 19. Russian language and Ukrainian translation also appeared.
Previously there was only English.
Active work on the program has basically begun. There were the last 476, and then since October of the 19th year the spot version appeared and it was actively updated where the list of changes to the add-ons, that is, on this site, we can download the diagnostic program itself. In principle, I already downloaded it for myself and unpacked it onto my computer in a separate folder, Victoria 523, now I'll connect myself. Hard drive to computer. The hard drive that we will check, now I have 3 disks and GP. Here the Victoria program is launched by the file victoria.exe. We launch it when you first start the program. you may have it in English. This language changes on the language tab. In this case, I have the Russian language selected, which means then I see here three hard drives, two of which are installed on my computer and
SSD partition bust.
Computer disk, but the external as media AC2115x250, that is, here we select it on the left we see the passport and that is, we see the model of the hard drive. Hard drive software version.
Serial number and size. Further.
The next tab is smart. These are self-diagnosis attributes, that is, the hard drive itself diagnoses itself, and here we can read this information and see, well, this hard drive writes that the status is good. State of health is good. If it's basically written here in red, then there's no point in testing further. Next, we are interested in the testing tab to know what we see. Just check the hard drive for errors and set it to mean reading the access method and ignore errors. Press the button scan scan. That means the scanning of the hard drive has begun. We see the volume of verified information, the speed at which it is scanned in percentage terms, and also here we have numbers that take this
access time to specific areas of the hard drive.
It is measured in milliseconds, that is, 5 milliseconds, 20, 50, 200, 600, more in errors.
Hard drive errors means if our scanning principle shows that everything is within 200 milliseconds of green, then this is considered normal and if the blocks arrive within 600 milliseconds, it's worth considering using this hard drive.
Especially in the red sector.
Well, if there are errors, it turns out that some block is not readable at all, then a little about checking the hard drive. That is, even if your computer starts and you want to check the hard drive, then the hard drive on which the system is installed from which the computer is installed is incorrect. For accurate scanning, it is necessary to remove the hard drive and install it on. Since I connected either just an additional hard drive to the system so that Windows would not load this hard drive, or as I said in principle,
make a bootable USB flash drive, put the Victoria program there, boot from this flash drive and scan the disk.
Our scanning is progressing so far, everything is normal, in principle, and the program has a lot of functions. But I will tell you only superficially for, so to speak, defining the disk.
Is he good or bad? Now we have three sectors.
4, 5.
Around 200 milliseconds. But this is still considered normal.
From experience, if there are defective sectors on the hard drive, they appear during the process of checking the first 10% of the hard drive. But in any case, to be completely sure, you need to scan up to 100% of the entire hard drive further.
Our scanning is perfect. Scanning again when the hard drive is not divided into CD partitions, and let's say there is no information on it, but unfortunately this happens extremely rarely.
Unfortunately, this happens extremely rarely, and we usually conduct testing this way.
A little more about the parameters here. We have reading mode means. We can set the recording mode, but the recording mode means zeroing out all our data, that is, it will simply erase the hard drive.
Recovery possibilities, that is, if we need to clean the hard drive without the possibility of restoring information, this happens, the same thing happens, connect it here, set the entry and
we completely go through the entire hard drive. There is also a mode here, we have set it to full scan, there is a full scan mode, there is a quick scan mode.
The fast scan mode is used only in cases where we have a known working hard drive, we just want to see what its write/read speed is. Scanning there is much faster further if we have
data will appear in the error sector, that is, there are some errors on the hard drive, you can try to fix them, erase them, or update them.
So as not to start checking the entire hard drive, in principle, we will see the sector on which this error popped up.
That is, we can copy the data and paste the sector number.
Where to start scanning?
Here in this field. Now he started scanning from scratch.
To the end, and we can allow scanning only part and try to correct these errors, but again from experience it depends on the number of errors.
Let's say if there are no more than 4 when checking the full hard drive, then in principle I can try to fix it, erase update.
If there are more of them, then the hard drive is only for replacement.
Or use it as a backup if it does not contain.
Very necessary information that I wouldn't want to lose. Well, the check passed 36% for us, as it were.
Almost diabetes has been tested out of 250 and we have only 6 in the green sector, this is considered normal.
While they are checking, we can, in principle, look at other tabs here, in principle, we also need information about.
Smart attributes are the information that we consider to be recorded on the hard drive during self-diagnosis, that is.
Here are some errors, too, there is a full transcript of all the errors, errors can be found on the program website, there is a full description of the critical and
there is nothing. But you can get acquainted with them, we are still testing.
So the test passed 8%, the entire volume of the hard drive was checked, which means, in principle, no errors have been found yet. Further, I won't check because I'm not sure.
If there are no errors on this disk, let's now try to connect another hard drive. By the way, this is a 3.5-inch disk that is installed in the computer. We will now connect a 2.5-inch laptop in the same way, which means we install the interrupted program. It is used at the user's request, in principle here. Everything seems to be fine with us. Close the program. Now I'll disconnect the disk, connect another one and... Two disks EF were determined. I launched the Victoria program again here as media. This disk is already hard for 160 GB of Hitachi and... That is, what smart functions are enabled now we will again read and get the smart attribute status good. Testing reading ignore errors start scanning. Here we have 26% checked and a warning pops up that one sector is earlier than 600 milliseconds. This is, more precisely, 577 seconds. The access time is no longer good for a hard drive. Here in the area of 6 gigabits, that is, 37% downloaded yet, not an error, but also. Response time is 2,434 milliseconds, this is generally very close to an error, that is, the same second one popped up a little later. ...5.6%, 9 gigabytes checked and our scanning just stopped completely. That is, the program cannot even ignore the error, a defect is detected but the scanning does not go further, that is, in principle, this is something. With this hard drive it will be very serious and it will definitely need to be replaced, again in principle the first thing. If you doubt that your hard drive is normal, you want to check it. First of all, before checking its Victoria programs or any other programs, it is better to try to save all the information from it to some other computer or hard drive. That's all. If you have questions, write in the comments.